Today we are going to really open up the OnePlus open, if you know what I mean. After doing my durability test, I've noticed that there's some black marks appearing on the screen, and I don't know if that's from dust or me bending it backwards one too many times, but we're going to take it apart and find out. We're also going to look for the titanium, carbon fiber, and quick note to everyone, including myself, since I am indeed a procrastinator, the last day you can order something online and still receive it by Christmas, at least here in the USA through regular mail, is December 16th, a few days left. Which is perfect since I have discounted all of my Jerry Rig Everything knives to just $9.99, and I don't know how many more days of that sale at that low of a price I can handle. Even the clear one is just $9.99. Watch out for your fingers. This public service announcement, of course, is brought by our channel sponsor, Stamps.com. Stamps.com makes shipping for small businesses incredibly fast and easy, since there's no waiting in lines. All of the shipping can happen right at home, from your own computer and your own printer. Here at Jerry Rig headquarters, we use recycled cardboard as packaging, as well as paper mailers. We don't use any of that plastic stuff that's going to end up in a landfill for the next 500 years. Stamps.com has massive discounts up to 89% off USPS and UPS rates, and will tell you the cheapest and fastest shipping option. And they connect seamlessly with every major marketplace and shopping cart. You can take care of orders on the go with the Stamps.com mobile app and schedule pickups right there from the online dashboard. For the past 25 years, Stamps.com has been helping people save time and money. Give your business the gift of Stamps.com this holiday season to make sure all of your mailing and shipping is covered. Sign up at Stamps.com/JerryRig for a 4-week trial, free postage, and free 5-pound digital scale. No long-term commitments or contracts, just how we like it. And I will get back to shipping these knives right after we finish the teardown. Let's get started. An interesting thing about this OnePlus open is that OnePlus is claiming their inner screen is made with ultra-thin glass, just like Samsung does with their Fold and Flip line of folding phones. Which makes me think that OnePlus is buying at least the inner folding display from Samsung, but I could be wrong. The bumpers that surround the edge of the flexible inner display are similar to what we see on other folding phones. These are very securely keeping the two halves of the soft flexible screen from touching each other as they fold shut. And with the bumpers gone, we can peel away a bit of that top, clear, permanent, protective plastic layer of the screen. And as you can see, this exterior layer is most definitely not supposed to be removed. It's peeling away and tearing apart in chunks, decorticating itself from the rest of the display. But we still haven't found any glass yet. To find the glass, we have to go deeper. Turns out the flexible displays are made up of layers, like onions or ogres. And some of these layers are integral to the functionality of the phone. The glass layer we're looking for is actually below the top plastics, but above the pixels. You can see the thin layer crack and shatter with my fingers, so that's good. We found the ultra-thin glass. And checked the UTG off of our teardown bingo board. Let's go deeper and see if we can find the carbon fiber and titanium. And we don't have to go too far. The black structure at the back of the folding screen is actually a solid carbon fiber panel. Not all carbon fiber is woven into an aesthetic grid like we see on sports cars. This looks more like a unidirectional non-woven slab with all the fibers running in the same direction. Extremely elegant and effective. Yeah, there's probably an engineer over at OnePlus who's fainted already watching this video, but in order for us to fully appreciate the ravishingly glorious internals of a smartphone, sometimes we gotta murder one. Thumbs up for that. At this point, we can also see some dirt did get inside underneath that middle display. So while the phone did continue to function directly after the main durability test, I think some dirt did find its way under the screen that caused black pressure spots to form after sitting around for a few weeks. So it would definitely be a good idea to keep your OnePlus open away from dust. Also, apparently, these gold screws in the hinge are made from titanium, but we'll get to those later. OnePlus is checking off all kinds of wins. I mean, this particular phone is dead, so it's not winning anything, but OnePlus in general is sitting pretty.
Speaking of glass, there is glass on the exterior non-folding display. I broke it, of course, for scientific purposes, so that I can show that normal displays have layers too. With the exterior screen gone, we glimpsed the largest battery we've seen so far in a folding phone, and it looks like OnePlus is using a SuperVolt battery from Oppo. We'll probably find another battery hiding under the far side of the phone if we can remove the back panel without it cracking, but with some heat and a brand new super sharp Jerry Rig Everything razor blade, I can slice down in between the recessed glass and the metal frame of the phone to pry the slab out from its enclosure. I call it the back glass, but let's be honest, there's more camera bump back here than glass at this point. But luckily it all comes off in one piece either way, leaving it the only part of this phone so far that is still in one piece. Now, I'm not gonna lie, I did think about counting every one of these screws out loud, which would have taken us at least a good 30 minutes, because it turns out OnePlus is using about 80 screws to hold this thing together. I say around 80 because I lost track at about 70, and I'm not going to go back through and count them all again. There's also a lot of foam balls inside of this upper loudspeaker, but I'm not counting those either. The OnePlus Open has 3 speakers and can do the spatial audio thing that the iPhones do. There's an incredibly pretty shade of blue gasketry underneath the battery ribbon cable, and I can remove the rear plastics that surround the camera bump. This has the single LED flash up in the far corner. If we unplug the Lego-style ribbon connector on the smaller of the two batteries, we can see it has a darker blue rubber gasket around the plug, which is interesting. Not sure why they're not the same color. The lower loudspeaker can also come out at this point, also with plenty of internal foam balls. These help the speaker sound more full, because it is full. The SIM card tray comes out, if you remember it's there in the first place, and the batteries can come out at this point as well, if you douse them in alcohol first and dangerously bend and pry them out of the aluminum frame. This is incredibly dangerous and I am not a fan. Normally OnePlus has some decent pull tabs in their phones, but this time around they've gone and made things difficult. On the back of the battery it says not to puncture, crush, heat, or burn, but the way they've installed the batteries makes crushing pretty much mandatory for removal. Telling us not to do a thing while making that specific thing part of the removal process is not very nice. And OnePlus needs to bring back the pull tabs. We find a total of 4,805 mAh worth of battery capacity inside the OnePlus Open. And while the permanent batteries are indeed annoying, I do gotta say this phone looks rather good inside. Laid out incredibly well with the nice gold accented ribbon cables. It's about this point we can also take out the main motherboard, leaving behind a bit of thermal paste residue where the board dissipates heat into the phone frame. We also find our main 48 megapixel camera sensor up in the top with OIS. The 64 megapixel telephoto periscope camera also has internal optical image stabilization, but the bottom 48 megapixel ultra-wide camera does not have any OIS. And yeah, OnePlus could have gotten away with a much smaller camera lens on the back. These three cameras are no larger than any other smartphone on the market right now, but with all smartphones basically being so similar in specs, the camera bump is one of the only differentiators, albeit only aesthetic. Digging our way deeper into the hinge of OnePlus's first folding phone, there are a few very interesting things. First off, we don't see any permanent caulking like we saw inside of the Samsung Flip and Fold. Instead, we have these red and blue rubber plugs. Effective to be sure, but not quite as permanent. Peeling back the gold ribbon cables, we can feed them through the frame body. After detaching the other half of the hinge, we see even more carbon fiber, the same non-woven stuff that's here to add lightweight structure to the hinge. Speaking of lightweight, OnePlus has found a way to work the word titanium into their marketing, while only using the premium titanium metal in the screws that hold the hinge together. Personally, I think this is brilliant. Apple probably spent tens of millions of dollars figuring out how to get a cosmetic ring of titanium attached to the iPhone 15 with solid-state diffusion, and here is OnePlus getting to use the same titanium terminology, riding the titanium wave Apple created, with a fraction of the R&D, just by adding titanium screws. And making generalized statements about the titanium materials in their marketing. Brilliant, and I ain't even mad. Titanium screws most definitely accomplish nothing inside of this hinge besides getting us to talk about the titanium, but it works. The titanium is here. The hinge itself moves with some very large springs and elongated gear in the center. OnePlus says there's 69 components in the hinge, which is probably true. I know I can't count that high though, so we're just gonna take their word on this one. Hit that subscribe button if you haven't already. I take apart smartphones fairly often, among other things. Thanks a ton for watching. I'll see you around.